Right. So here we have our pack. I got excited initially because I was like, ooh, Planeswalker, but Elspeth's not that great. And then come on the Shark Typhoon. Oh, Icy Manipulator though. What a card. Is Icy Manipulator just ever not the pick? Take Ruin Crab first up. Really like taking Icy here. Yep. Okay. Looks like we are in business. So I can take whatever I like from here because I took a colorless card first pick. I'm not taking Doomfortold, I know that much. There's always so many good choices. Yeah, for some reason I just want to take Gifted Aetherborn, but it's not the most powerful card. I guess Auron's Epiphany, given that I have not gone in any direction as of yet. Could take Throne and then draft some kind of aggro deck, but that doesn't really make much sense. Yeah. Live the dream. Alright, so here we have Eldest Reborn. We also have Binding of the Old Gods. Eldest Reborn, quite good because it can reanimate from any graveyard, so if their deck happens to have some good things, then could get that. There's also Young Pyromancer and Sprite Dragon, so blue-red spells, if it's a thing. I drafted one of those and it was an absolutely garbage deck. Binding the Old Gods. Or Eldest Reborn. I'll just take the Eldest Reborn. It is really tempting to just take this and play 5 color again. I played a 5 color deck a few days ago and it was so much fun. So much fun. Alright. And if we just have a look at the other players. No one that I recognize. Alright, so we just took a black card. So, Fatal Push seems reasonable. Priest I need to do some more work for. Niv-Mizzet if I wanted to go the 5 color direction. Though, I could also take a Danto Vanguard. It's an aggressive creature. But for now, we'll take Fatal Push. Dreadhorde Invasion. I presume it's just like in War of the Spark. Absolutely terrible. Because you end up just killing yourself over and over. Rashmi. Wait, Rashmi was really good when I read it last. Just be disciplined. Probably was supposed to take Rashmi just as a much better card. But here, we could try and do like mono black aggro. Is that a thing? Surely not. But we can try. I mean, Lazatep Reaver's not that good a card, so maybe that comes back on the wheel, and that would go in such a deck. We're gonna try it. Ooh, Woestrider seems good, especially because we have Fatal Push. Oh, what does this card do? Okay, don't care about that one. Bibblesip. Fairgrounds Warden. Or Judith. Would be cards I would be thinking about. But right now we're kind of just going in. Alright, now we have to pick something different. So, with that in mind, could take Atrus because it's half in our colours, could take the land. Take Atrus. I'm not sure if that was the right. Okay. The right pick, but then there's not anything really in black. There's Village Rites, but I don't love playing Village Rites, even in a deck that can take advantage with it of it with like Dread Wanderer. Could get Mythos of Aluna to copy their good things, or we could play a Sharky Boy. And the Shark Typhoon came back. Right. So there's lots of blue here. Lots of blue. A black card still in the pack. We'll take Shark Typhoon. And we'll play a blue-black thing. Okay. Two came back, so it must not be a thing. We'll take Godless Shrine. I really thought this was a good card. Whenever you cast your first spell, sorry, hang on, let me click this first. Whenever you cast your first spell, each turn reveal the top card of your library. You may cast it without paying its mana cost if it's a spell with less converted mana cost. To me, that seems good. We'll take the Priest. We'll take Thirst for Meaning, not sure we'll play it, and then we'll take Illyrios. Oh, Illyrios and Throne combo. Right, so there's a Heartless Act. Or there's a Castle Lochthwain, or there's a Sigiled Sword of Valoron. What a card. Army in a can on an enchantment. Not enchantment, artifact. Right. So, take the removal spell. We'll just let everyone think about it for a little bit, but that's what we're taking. Illyrios makes two bodies. Guess I'll take Bubble Snare. Overfeed the Swarm. There's an Ashaya. Ashaya is so good against Binding of the Old Gods. So rude. Alright. Choice. Take Kaya. I think we have to just take Kaya. I think what I learnt last time is that you need to play over the top. At the moment, our strategy is too fair. And I think Akai will help us in that regard. We will take Brazen Borrower. It does go with our existing strategy. Luckily, we also took that Godless Shrine. So I don't think we're playing the throne. So what coming, I think, comes in here at this point. Now we have Scrap Heap Scrounger as a recursive threat because we are in black already. Seems decent. Sea Dasher Octopus. I think we just play a tempo style game. While I would like the Sea Dasher, I will not take it here. If it came back a last pick, sure. Alright, so I think I might be a little light on creatures, but I'm just going to break them apart to see. All right, so we'll take the Storm Tamer. Goes pretty much with what we're trying to do here. So maybe upgrade Bubble Snare and get a few more nice creatures. So the question here is Castle Lockline or Seagate Restoration? And for me, it's going to be the castle, I think. Yeah. So there was a blue-white land in the pack with Kaya, which would be nice. Get that and maybe another free fixer, and then I can just play it without too much cost. Alright. Lots of white cards. Yeah, so this is the pack I was talking about. And I think because we want to play Kaya, if at all possible, then we'll take the white one rather than the dual land that's definitely in our colours. And there's another free one. So we'll take that over Slitherblade. And so far we have 19 playables. What's this do? We're not playing it. But it can go in the sideboard. It's fine. So we're looking to replace Bubble Snare and get a few more good creatures. Alright. Okay. I guess splash two planeswalkers. Valkyrie is at least castable in my normal colours, so. Hopefully get Steam Vents or Blightstep Pathway back. Disallow and Essence Scatter also release more cards for our deck. Alright. So we'll take Blood Chief's Thirst here over. We're not going to play Search. We're not like a full-on control deck. And the other card we could think about would be Sphinx's Revelation off the white splash. But we'll just take the removal spell. So we've upgraded Bubble Snare. So that was objective one. Now, Hostage Taker, Champion of Wits. We don't have a lot of card draw. But I think Hostage Taker is still probably better anyway. There is a Vraska's Contempt obviously in the pack. But I want to have enough creatures. Speaking of creatures, we have Warkite Marauder and Yorion. Yorion in this deck has value from Illyrios, Woe Strider, Atrus, Hostage Taker. Versus an annoying flyer thing. So this deck looks reasonable, but I'm still concerned that it might just be a little bit too low a power level. It's not trying to do something that goes over the top. Because that has been my experience in Arena Cube so far. It also has value off of Eldest Reborn. How many cards do we have that we could potentially play? Could we get to a 60 card deck? Could we do it? 20. Alright. Destroy creature, or Fae of Wishes, or a Wrath, but the Wrath is not great in our deck. I'll take the Mythos, I think. Alright, so in terms of going big, we have Sublime Epiphany and Godfarer's Gift. Godfarer's Gift, at the beginning of combat on your turn, exile a creature from your graveyard, make it a 4/4 with haste. It does not die. Or Sublime Epiphany, do all the things in the world. Okay. Seagate Stormcaller. Heartless Act, Into the Royal Fatal, push Bloodsheath Thirst. This could actually be reasonable in our deck. So we'll take Steam Vents. this pack doesn't help us in our dream of playing Yorion as a companion. Neither really does this pack. But it does give us a card that will go in our deck. Okay, so we're not doing the Yorion companion. We have too many lands for it. Crippling Fear came back. Neutralize. And the Folio. So if we wanted to go the mill plan, we have Folio plus Ashiok. So if our deck turns out not very good on the first one or two games, then we could pivot and go Ashiok, Crippling Fear, Folio of Fancies in, probably Bubble Snare in as well, because then we're slowing down. If we just have a look, is Priest of the Forgotten Gods good enough? Maybe. Doesn't seem great. These counter spells. Once I foretell it, they're going to play around it as if it's a counter spell anyway, so really it's a bit more of a mystery this way if I do it. Alright, so if we look at our lands now, we have 1, 2, 3, 8 blue sources, 8, 9 blue sources, we have 7, 9 black sources, and our 1 steam vent, so then if we happen to have it, then we can play Valky as Tibble. Hello to those who've joined, welcome. I'll periodically be checking the chat, so if you want to roast me for some horrible misplay that I did, feel free. Or you can just say what you're thinking. It might get through to me one way or another. Alright, we'll keep this and play Gifted Aetherborn on turn 2. We are on the play, so we're gonna start smashing. So they went to 6. Just Bloodsheaf's Thirst, or we could hold Stormcaller. Or something like that. Though it turns out Right, so we attack here. I really want to draw a land so I can go Stormcaller plus Bloodchief's Thirst Kicked. And if I play Yorian here, then A, I have 4/5 in the air, B, I get my reflection back. What a shame. We'll still attack. I'll take the 2 cards. So here we killed Giant Killer, Aspirant, Attack. And hold up Mythos. That works, right? Yep, that works. So enters the battlefield, copy the next instant or sorcery. Yeah, so I cast this normally. Then I play Bloodchief first. Shooting this. Attack for 6. If they want to block, then I can kill their Phoenix forever. If not, I can just kill Apparition. Get a 2/2.
Really like fire, okay?
Because I can Sublime Epiphany. This that went pretty well. Alright, so keeping on. If all the games play out like that, I'll be very surprised, but they were kind of on the back foot. They didn't do anything for the first 2 turns that was meaningful. I will keep and be disappointed that we are on the draw, because we have this 2/1 that wants to attack. Okay, in that case, we we don't have this 2-1 that wants to attack, they have a dead elf. If they're playing Llanowar Elf, it's for a reason, and it's because they want to get to big things. Also, potentially they took a risky hand. Okay, they didn't do a risky one lander. Sometimes I do that and get punished. So I played Dread Wanderer. Play this tap land. And then they'll be amazed when I have an island. I'll just hold fatal push up. If they had land great hand, that would be bad. I need to kill that instead. Do have to, and they're telling me that they have snakeskin veil or something, right? Yep. Taking the two cards. Do want to hit my land drops? Two. Interesting that they cared more about Brazen Borrower than Heartless Act. The Godless Shrine actually being useful here to cast Yorion, given I only have single blue. Because they're the Yorion, I really don't want to block. So if they could just not attack. Oh man. Alright. Kill it now. No, not really. An attack would appear to be loose on this board. Kill that, I'll play Aetherborn and I'll cycle better wood. And then they presumably don't attack again. And then I can hold up Sublime Epiphany and actually get some value off of the copy target creature. To be slightly stuck on. Yep. X is 0 to make my wild form preserve. Okay. Seems an interesting play. I'll cycle it. I'll block. Scry that to the bottom. I can cast this when I have yeah, so I can do it this turn. So I do this. I do this. Sure, that's just big, right? Keyword big. Yeah, that's fine. Don't like going to 2, so I won't. And I will hold up my dudes and pass. Them having Bonders Enclave is pretty good here. I say as they draw cards. Alright, how about we counter that? Return. Copy. Target player draw. So, I will return the thing that does not have an ETB. I will copy Illyrios. I will target me. I'll keep this one. Spell for one mana. No, that just passed into combat. Opponent thinking. He's saying, do you want to triple block? And I am saying yes. Only had the red mana. But I don't, so I'm not gonna get greedy. Oh, Elder Gargroth. Thank you. So now what I actually want to do is kill this. Play this, get this, attack the four. Next turn, they're forced to play the mammoth, so then they can potentially draw cards off Bonder's Enclave. And then next turn, I make Valky into Elder Gargroth and just start smashing. They cannot block. They could draw a card here, or they could play Kazandu Mammoth. Yeah. I agree. I will draw a card. Right. turn. Sure. Okay. So they block, take 3 of that, but still take 9. GG. Valky taking the Gargaroth. That was pretty good. Oh, got some extra people who've just come to join. Hello to those who have recently joined. I'm 2-0 so far. We've drafted this blue-black, I don't know, kind of tempo. Not really. And it's splashing white for Kaya off of 3 dual lands. And there's 1 steam vents to potentially cast Valky as Tybalt. That's the duel that I was talking about. This hand does not appear very good. But it does something. Namely, bounce something. Okay. I'll let them put the counter. They were clever. I might bounce. This anyway. Pass here. Really do need to draw black source. Like now. That would be a no. We could just die. Black source, please. Alright, so they play the captain, and then I'm dead next turn if I draw nothing. Nine black. Oh man. So I cycle. Okay, we're dead. That land was one turn too late. We're certainly not in a good spot. If that land was untapped, but maybe we weren't just straight dead. Anyway. Well, I have my red. Are they gonna draw a thought seed straight away? I'd probably take Atrus, I guess. Don't know what their hand is, but seems reasonable to me. Could have played the swamp because then I have the 2/3 death touch dude whose name I'm forgetting right now. Okay, I'm just gonna play Valky. See what their hand is doing. Alright, Valky's dying. Got it. Have a two lander, they're playing Mardu and they have no red. Now they do. So I'm definitely in the market of attacking them. If they attack the Scrounger, I will block. Okay. So we're not drawing well. But I'll kill this so I can attack. And they don't draw a card. Spell is bad against the Lurios because they could kill the 3/2. But that basically activates the 2/3. We'll pass. Taking 3 here. I should have put a stop because I wanted to stop that. Well, expect this to die. Yep. That was a good draw. So we attack. can't activate Crawling Vengeance, so we're tapped out of it. Then we play Yorion, Flickering Illyrios, getting another 3-2. Oh, so they could activate the flame, but they could make the creature. They play the elixir. How many of those do you do? Yep. Bontu is a good card. We have drawn woefully. The elixir, go to 12, block a 3-2. Alright, this is fly. No, okay. Removal spell off the top. So if I cycle for one and hit a removal spell, all right, we didn't. They can activate the Scrounger. So I needed to attack with more? Question mark. Oh, that was confusing my brain. I did make a mistake. Right. And they have the Crawling Baron, so I think I was supposed to cycle this. And if there's a 3 mana removal spell, then, well, gee, I got punished. Yep. So I played incorrectly at the end there, but in the end it didn't matter. But I should have cycled the neutralize on my turn in case I found like into the royal or fatal push or blood chief's thirst. I think I used the other 3 mana removal spell, the mythos, already that game. Or maybe in a previous turn I should have double blocked. Yeah, I think that's probably better. Instead of blocking the Lurus, I maybe was supposed to double block Bontu. This is a keep. So I get to play Scrounger in all likelihood. What would that be? Poison the cup? That would Doomscar. They're clicking it and clicking their foretold card, so I feel like it's Poison the Cup. And then they're like, so can't block, is attacking. On top. I can't believe I picked that throne second pick. That was an awful decision. Exiling Moist Rider is pretty relevant. Oh, hello. Cards. So what we really want to do is be able to go Eldest Reborn, Yorion. No, I will not block. Could probably block with my goat, but you know, it's fine. Contempt, nice grounder. Fair enough. Oh, Eldest Reborn. So I'm going to be greedy here. And I'm going to into the world my own Eldest Reborn. Icy Manipulator can wait. Oh, but I can't do it with Kicker, so I guess it won't wait, and I'll just do it now. Hey, two life. Play this. Last turn. Beginning of your end step if you gain life this turn. Sure. If they play Wost Rider, then I kill the goat and then play Yorion and kill Wost Rider and flicker Eldest Reborn again. Which seems good to me, to be honest. They got rid of the creatures, so I don't have anything to get from there. They discarded God Pharaoh's Gift, which is good for me. Represent I could have a counter spell. Alright, so this Eldest Reborn has been a 5 for 1. One more card in their bin so then they can get Ghost Rider back. Would have liked to counter that, but you know, that's fine. So now I pass the turn. Whoops. I was supposed to tap it, I just forgot.
To choose my own fate and yours.
Oh, you can okay. Scream if
holding
it hurts too
lands.
Much.
Tap this. An annoying card. I'm just gonna counter. Yeah. So I guess I had Icy Manipulator, so I didn't really need to. I shouldn't hold it.
You think too much. Them.
They sack the goat here? No? Alright. Okay, they got paid off for not sacking the goat. Seems good. I'll play this.
I just want to get in, get out, and finish the job.
Exile. The aspirant. Deal them three. Put my stop. Oh,
sorry
then.
For your loss.
Yep. Don't know what they would want. They binned Fondue Inversion from the Liliana. Plane of Cleansing is not in the set. I feel we're in a pretty good spot here. Feel in a lot less good spot. Okay, yeah. I will sacrifice this goat. That's got to be about the best draw possible. Okay, so I'm going up with Kaya. On this.
Ghosting feels weird, right? I have no interest in fighting fair.
Okay. I guess the lantern's not that good against Kaya. Until they get eight lands. Okay.
Spirit.
So I have 10 on board. I can, yeah, sure. That means they're not dead next turn.
actually, yes they are. I'll sack Illyrios here. Exile this.
It's the least.
Tap this. Kill this. Get the good game. Uptick.
We're doing things my way.
Alright. Yeah, Liliana was good, must say. And I didn't mind the old 5-for-1 Eldest Reborn. Actually, I flickered it a couple of times, so what was it? 7-for-1 Nice. Right, I need a couple more wins so then I can get back me money. Hello to those in the chat. Remember, if you want to share any thoughts, feel free to drop them in there. No black mana seems bad. I could cycle. And I have the scry, and I'm on the draw. I talked myself into it. It's not a land. Go. Right. Do I do it now? Really want to. They could disallow this if they really wanted to. I didn't know this card was in there, in the cube. All right, we did it. We know, we just know that they have a counter spell though. So, maybe we just hold up ours. Maybe we play Dread Wanderer, hold up Brazen Borrow Bounce. Yeah, I like that. So they played nothing on their turn and they had a definite stop. So sure. What do they have? The shark? I can't bounce it to prevent them from drawing a card. Thank you.
goats. I will take that land. They've so far done a whole bunch of nothing. And I have played Waste Rider 3 times. If only these goats were 1/1s. How good would that be? Ah, okay. I understand. I'm with it now. So writes down. Does it show me on their deck? It does. Okay, cool. I kind of want to play Petty Theft and Brazen Borrower, attack for 8, or I can just do this and draw a card and take 5. Yeah, okay. No, I can't draw a card. I need an extra black for that. We still think they have Disallow. I really do. So I think next turn I'm going to play a Naked Elvis Reborn. They have removal spell. Alright, go to attacks. Now that I do the attack, I will not play my Naked Elvis Reborn. I'm keeping Sublime Epiphany, I know that much, but then here, that leaves 5 mana. I'll play this. Just as a bit more pressure, maybe? Yep. Could have Wrath, but I can't really play around it. That I have to counter, and then they counter, and then they can't draw a card this turn, but they can draw 2 cards next turn, and then I can play Sublime Epiphany when they actually go for it. Wow. still think this is this loud, but maybe it's not. These goats are doing nothing for me, so I am going to sack them. So, 3 cards. They need to draw before they have it. Yeah. Okay. 3 cards. What if I do this? I could just be dead. One, two, five, six, seven, eight, nine. This. Sure. Right, 2 cards away. So, draw 2 cards. Kills me. Wow. Sure. Really wish I had a land. But if they have any counter spell, I'm dead. Is it? It is a sorcery. At least I have that going for me. At least I have that going. Thank you. to counter it. I'm selecting targets. This is a miracle. Or does it let you select all the things you want to do? Alright. Alright. Okay, so now the question for them is how do they win? Right? So can someone tell me whether there's a card in the cube which gets back instants and sorceries from the graveyard? So I'm going to cast Tybalt here, not Tybalt, Valkyrie. They're going to play Sailor. I'm going to kill Sailor. So, I can kill this now. Pass the turn. Yeah, sure. Not playing Vanishing Light. Interesting. I'll take your responder hostage. Passing it purely so then if they wrath and they don't get it back. They go to 5. They're dead through... Well, they're one. Yep, that's fine. They counter it, that's good. It's fine. Now I'll play Illyrios. Land Stormcaller. Five power, so they have to kill the reflection or put the blocker out, but I have them dead through a blocker. Yeah. Okay.
As innocent people are here, let me help.
Right, did we do it? We did it against Second Sunrise Control. Feel pretty good about that. We're at the four wins, so we're no longer a total chump, but we won our five wins, so then we've made our money. Hopefully you're enjoying the stream so far. We'll keep this. We have Aetherborn into Illyrios. They mulliganed. Twice. Five. Our hand's very good against the person who just went down to five, I would say. Right on time. Tell you what, Illyrios has been quite good. Quite good. I would like that to die. So they have to kill Atrus. Or
or play Land Wrath. That would be good.
Yep. So they could have killed Atrus, gone to one.
But then, even if they do find the Wrath off the top, then Brazen Borrow kills them. Anyway. Right.
Tale of two very different games there. Opponent Miles to 5 versus the previous one where they cast the second Sunrise. Right.
This is a keep. It also has Seagate Stormcaller into Fatal Push or into the Royal, which is kind of cool. Don't like that card. I think I'm playing Valky next turn. The other thing about Valky in my deck, the other way I'm going to go off is Eldris Reborn. Well, okay. So if they go skewer, then play a 2/2, then I just kill cleric and the 2/2. Now I can't. Opponent, you can have a turn. Surely. Right, so I play this. I wait for the trigger to resolve, then I cast this, and I copy it. And kill the cleric also. You can keep chipping me for one, but it's fine. Actually, a good target for me to hostage take. Here I want to attack. And I want to start being mean. And I'm going to play Icy Manipulator. I'm going to tap their land on upkeep. I
So they need to draw two more lands to play Chandra. That does get them back to Warden. That's okay though. I'll play a 3-2. And I will do the same thing. That does not help me against the Chandra because it can't be countered. I will attack. I'll kill the Warden. This comes in. Yeah, that's a good card.
I know. I am hot, aren't I? Oh, today's my lucky day.
Thank gosh. So I'll bounce this with kicker. And then end turn upkeep. Chandra is still going to be a beating. So I can kill it next turn. I like how they played the land first. I'll counter this. I'll deal with Chandra.
Is it just
I have
me?
9 turns.
Or is it getting a little warm in here?
I think I should be fine.
And
I will hold up Epiphany. now they're on a two-turn clock. GG. All right. What are you getting? Sublime Epiphany. That's cute. They're not dead. Opponent, what you got? Pump with castle. Am I dead? Oh my god. Wow. Who saw that one coming? Who saw that coming? Yeah. Wow. What a way to lose. I was so sure I was going to that 7 game. I was so certain. This was the deck. This should have been 6. I got greedy with my Icing Manipulator and I didn't play around them drawing Embercleave and a land. Mistakes were made. Lost an unlosable. Nice.